Today's new topic is smart storage technology, and in which we have to need. First point is role of storage in smart grid. Okay, also in which there are various example of storage system like batteries, ACMS, and also in which we have to need storage electricity in the form of batteries. For example, we are using solar cell. Then solar cell convert sunlight into electrical energy, but this electrical energy is stored in the form of DC charge in batteries. That means solar cell is produce large amount of electricity, because in which the sunlight is a ray is totally depends on day, because sun is shining and it gives large amount of sunlight, and this sunlight is very useful to transfer in the form of electrical energy with the help of photovoltaic cell. Also this sunlight is connected to the grid and storaged large amount of power. Also in sun electricity, more fluctuating energy sources, because for example sun, wind and power are connected to the grid, because it is very difficult to improve the stability of the system, because supply and demand is very important in storage in smart grid. Also in which we have to need energy storage system, because it is very important to develop the future to smart storage technology. Also in which we have to need different efficient pump storage electrical power station, also useful for long term storage system. And this is the exact role of the storage system is totally depends on the consumer, because there are industrial consumer, then domestic consumer, depend on demand of the consumer. And this is the exact role of storage in smart grid. This totally depends on the energy sources like sun, wind, energy. Okay, now also in which we have to need different types of storage technology. For example, batteries, then SMES, that is superconducting magnetic energy storage system, then pump hydro system and compressed air energy storage system. These are the four types of the storage technology. Okay, now in your syllabus we have to need this four point is very important in smart storage technology. Okay, then first point is batteries, because large amount of batteries used in grid. Okay, also for example, this is generation side, this is transmission side, and this is distribution side. For example, we have consider wind energy, then consider sunlight, that is photovoltaic cell. At that instant we have to need batteries to increase the generation side, but also in batteries we have to need inverter, because stored electricity in the form of DC, then this DC voltage converted into AC, then again transfer to the generation, and then finally batteries is connected to the total whole system, and this system concept is called as batteries in grid. That means we have connected batteries, that is batteries is connected to the grid with the help of wind energy storage system and sunlight, that is photovoltaic cell energy storage system. And this is the uses of batteries in grid. Also batteries is connected to the grid, but in which we have to need to stabilize power distribution network, but in batteries we have to need converter, that is called as solid state converter, and this convert DC to AC. Okay, now this is the exact working of the solid state converter. For example, we have considered RICO system. That means the capacity of RICO system is 20 megawatt for 15 minutes, and the power of the RICO system in 1 hour is 5 megawatt, and is used to stabilize the frequency of the system. That means RICO system is better for 20 megawatts. Also, we have to consider 27 megawatt power for 15 minute. Then it require 6.75 megawatt hour. That in that instant we have to use nickel cadmium battery. Now this is the first concept developed in Alaska in 2003 with the help of long transmission line. And finally, this system get stabilized. Now this is the exact importance of batteries using power transfer from one station to another station, but in which we have to need batteries, and the rating of batteries nickel cadmium batteries and depends on consumer side. Okay, also in market so many batteries are available, that is sodium ion batteries, sodium sulfur batteries, because these batteries are very inexpensive, but in which this type of batteries are used in Japan and United States for improve the storage capability or storage capacity of the system. And this is the smart storage technology, like batteries using smart grid. Okay, then also this is the battery storage power station, and this type of battery is used in power plant. Okay, and this type of battery is electrochemical battery. Also this type of battery used in pump storage technology, and the capacity of batteries depends on power, and the power, the maximum power capacity of the power station in 1000 megawatt, and it depends on battery storage. Also in battery storage power station, the power in the form of kilowatt or megawatt, and the rating of the station increase, then capacity of the battery always increase, and the capacity of battery decrease, then the capacity of power station is decreased, then capacity of battery always decrease. That means the ratio of batteries is depends on the rating of power, that is kilowatt and megawatt. This is the concept of battery storage in power station. Also, okay, there are the different types of batteries, that is flow batteries, liquid metal battery, then sodium ion batteries, then lead acid batteries, then sodium sulfur batteries, then nickel cadmium batteries, then aluminum ion and lithium ion. These are the different types of batteries using smart grid storage technology. Then also technology comparison from grid level applications, and these are the different types of batteries, that is flow batteries, then liquid metal batteries, then sodium ion, lead acid batteries, then sodium sulfur batteries, nickel cadmium batteries, aluminum ion batteries and lithium ion batteries. In flow batteries, moving parts are present, and other batteries there is no moving parts in batteries. Also room temperature are present in flow batteries, also lead acid batteries present, देन निकेल कैडमियम बैटरीज रूम टेम्परेचर प्रेजेंट एल्यूम एल्यूमिनियम आयन एंड लिथियम आयन एंड इन विच ऑलवेज ऑपरेशन ऑफ द रूम टेम्परेचर प्रेजेंट देन ऑल्सो इन विच द कंसेप्ट ऑफ फ्लेमेबल एंड इनफ्लेमेबल इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन लिक्विड मेटल बैटरीज कंसेप्ट आर प्रेजेंट सोडियम आयन प्रेजेंट एंड लिथियम आयन प्रेजेंट एंड अदर बैटरीज आर नॉन फ्लेमेबल ऑल्सो टॉक्सिक मटेरियल नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज टॉक्सिक मटेरियल कंसेप्ट एंड टॉक्सिक मटेरियल्स आर प्रेजेंट इन बैटरीज दैट इज फ्लो बैटरीज इन विच टॉक्सिक मटेरियल ऑलवेज प्रेजेंट देन लीड एसिड बैटरीज इन विच टॉक्सिक मटेरियल ऑलवेज प्रेजेंट देन सोडियम सल्फर बैटरीज एंड निकेल कैडमियम बैटरीज इन विच टॉक्सिक मटेरियल्स आर प्रेजेंट ओके देन अदर बैटरीज इन विच टॉक्सिक मटेरियल्स आर नॉट प्रेजेंट देन इन प्रोडक्शन लीड एसिड बैटरी ऑलवेज प्रेजेंट सोडियम सल्फर बैटरीज देन निकेल कैडमियम एंड लिथियम आयन इन विच कंटिन्यूसली प्रोडक्शन ऑकर देन अदर बैटरीज इज डिपेंड्स ऑन द रिक्वायरमेंट्स ऑफ कस्टमर देन नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज रेयर मेटल्स देन इन निकेल कैडमियम बैटरीज इन विच रेयर मेटल्स आर प्रेजेंट और रेयर मटेरियल्स डिपेंड्स ऑन मेटल एंड नॉन मेटल्स ओके देन अदर बैटरीज इन विच रेयर मेटल्स आर नॉट प्रेजेंट एंड दिस इज द टेक्निकल कंपेरिजन फॉर ग्रिड लेवल एप्लीकेशंस एंड दिस टेक्निकल कंसेप्ट टोटली डिपेंड्स ऑन द कैपेसिटी ऑफ द बैटरी एंड इन विच इन दिस टेबल टेक्नोलॉजी कंपेरिजन फॉर ग्रिड लेवल एप्लीकेशन दैट मीन्स दिज आर द technology comparison based on technology moving parts operation at room temperature then flammable toxic metals or toxic materials in production and rare metal these are the technology comparison for grid level in application okay then next point is superconducting magnetic energy storage system and this topic is very important and also in which we have to need magnetic energy storage system and in which this energy storage system in which the magnetic energy storage in which the magnetic field created with the help of superconducting coil because this superconducting coil create magnetic field in energy storage system with the help of direct current flowing through it and also in which temperature ratio is very important and also superconducting magnetic energy storage system consists of superconducting coil then power conditioning system then refrigeration system that means there are three typical SMS system based on superconducting coil, power conditioning system, and cryogenically cooled refrigeration system. In superconducting coil is charged, and small amount of current flowing through it, and at that instant the magnetic field created by the flow of direct current in the superconducting coil, and finally store energy. In superconducting magnetic coil and finally this energy storage can be applied to the and can be used for smart grid technology then this type of advanced magnetic energy storage system is called as superconducting magnetic energy storage system and this magnetic energy storage system based on three part that is superconducting coil then power conditioning system and cryogenically cooled refrigeration system now this is the overview of the superconducting magnetic energy storage system now this is the circuit diagram of the superconducting magnetic energy system and in which store electrical energy in the form of magnetic field, and this magnetic field generated by superconducting coil when direct current, that is DC current flowing through the superconducting magnetic coil, and magnetic field generated, and finally electrical energy stored in the form of magnetic field. Also, this type of energy storage system can recharge within the minutes and can be repeat the charging discharging sequence thousands of time without any degradation of the magnets. And this is the advanced energy storage technology of the superconducting energy storage system. That means this is the advanced energy storage system as compared to the battery, and in which so many liquids are used, that is helium, nitrogen, argon, different types of liquid used in this type of battery, and in which use superconducting magnetic coil. When DC current is applied to the superconducting magnetic coil, then current flowing through the magnetic coil, and then magnetic field produce, and this magnetic field produce, and finally this magnetic field produce the flux, and this flux are linking to each other, and then finally small amount of current flowing through it, and finally is in the form of electrical energy, and this electrical energy can be used for storage technology in smart grid. And this is the exact working principle of superconducting magnetic energy storage system. Then concept of stored electrical energy. Then stored electrical energy in the form of magnetic field. Then superconductor have zero resistance at low temperature. Then also in which very low ohmic heat dissipation. Then energy storage in the form of formula with respect to energy storage is equal to 1 half Li square. That means length of superconducting coil and square of the current flowing through the coil, and this type of energy measured in joule. Now this is the concept of superconducting magnetic energy storage system, and this is the overview of the superconducting magnetic energy storage system. Okay, now this is the energy storage system, and in which we have to use superconducting coil. Okay, and this is the coolant port used for cooling purpose. Also, in which we have to need inner and outer coil, and in which inner coil, for inner coil input side we have to apply electric current, that is DC current. Then this DC current are flowing through the SMBN, that is superconducting coil, and this superconducting coil produce magnetic field, and this magnetic field produce magnetic flux, and this magnetic flux are linking to each other, and finally small amount of current flowing through it, and this type of small amount of current in the form of DC, and this DC current is useful for storage energy in the form of DC, and this DC charge useful for smart grid technology. Now this is the overview of the superconducting magnetic energy storage system. Okay, now we can stop here.